Friends, as we enter 2023, today we'll discuss 7 technical career roadmaps which you could pursue in the coming year. These career roadmaps have been very important, not only for this year, but for the coming decade. So let's discuss these 7 skills or 7 career roadmaps which you could pursue in 2023. So friends, the very first career option we have is management. Pretty much anywhere you go, in any field you go, you would need someone to manage your project, your product, your deliveries, your deadlines, your stakeholders. You need experienced people to come on board and manage your project or product. And that's why management would always be relevant. So the very first is project management or product management or agile or scrum project delivery. So you could be a certified scrum master. There are various certifications you can opt for. You can be a project management professional, PMP, a PRINCE2 certified, which is very famous in Europe. PSPO is a professional scrum and product owner certification. So all these options are there in the management line. And also the good thing about management is that even if you are not from a technical background, but you have managed people, process and products, maybe outside IT industry, that is still relevant and you can use or utilize that, that experience along with some relevant industry certification and choose this career roadmap. The second career path, which is somewhat my career path, you can say, is cloud. Now, when I say cloud is a very wide field, and that's why I have given it as a dedicated career path. But within cloud, you can think of as if the whole IT industry is now on the cloud. So pretty much whatever roles you were playing in traditional IT are more or less would be there in cloud industry as well. But to highlight some of the roles to start with are cloud engineers, cloud architects, cloud network engineers, cloud support representative. Now just replace these roles with your traditional IT industry roles. So these roles are not very different from those kind of roles if you have already played it. The only difference is these roles would be played on that specific cloud platform. So it could be GCP, it could be AWS, it could be Azure, it could be Oracle. And then you have to learn that cloud platform to be able to perform these roles. But the good thing about cloud is that there is a wide pool of jobs, wide pool of roles which could be opted for. And that's why it's very accommodating. And if you really ask me, in the last decade, whatever new technologies emerged, like big data, AI, ML, Hadoop, cybersecurity, cloud computing, and many else, cloud is the only industry which has really evolved in the last decade or so. While some of the other industries are still evolving, but I would rate cloud right at the top because these giants have really captured the market and they have come up with some of the finest cloud products. And there are specific certifications provided by all these different cloud vendors in all these different areas. You can go and check, simply type Google Cloud certifications or AWS cloud certifications and they will directly give you the list of all the certifications those are available. So please see if this is the right career path for you and yeah, just go about it. Data industry is the fastest growing in the IT world today. And we heard this term almost a decade back, which is data is the new oil. And indeed, it has been like an oil for any industry. There are so many different things happening in the data world today that you could see that the list goes on and on. But if you have to start your journey in data or if you are already working in the data industry, you know that data engineering, data architect, data analyst, data managers, all these different fields are there. Data operations, which is called as data ops, also also deals with managing data on cloud. So you need to decide which specific path you have to choose within the data industry. If you come from a software engineering background and if you already know coding and coding languages like Python, Java, a lot of these things, especially around data engineering, designing data pipelines, happens today through these coding languages. So you definitely have an edge. On the other side, if you come from an Excel background where you have been analyzing or wrangling data in Excel or some sort of a BI technology, then you can go into a data analyst role, or you can opt for BI and analytics kind of a path wherein you are focusing more on the product part of it. You could be a Tableau expert, you could be a Power BI developer, all those kind of certifications you could do, or else you can be a certified data engineer on any of the cloud. There are various certifications, so you have to explore it yourself. Another very important field within the data, which has now become a world of its own, is data science. And we'll discuss about it very soon. But all these different roles which I have noted here, you could pick or focus on one specific path among all these and go about it. And very interestingly, you now have data managers, which comes and connects with the management field, wherein a data manager's job would be to manage a team of data engineers, data scientists, data analysts. So if you come from a management background, if you want to move into management, you can focus on getting into the data management area. How we can imagine IT world without software engineering? We cannot, right? So if you love coding, and if you want to develop something, if you want to see the real life application of something, I think this is the best field. Although it demands enough understanding of the coding languages, and you need to have a lot of hands-on experience to enter this field. So to just list out some of the famous languages which are in demand today would be Angular and React.js. These are based on JavaScript language as a platform and are used to develop web front-end application. So the next language is Python. Python is really popular when it comes to the data industry, but Python has some very strong frameworks for web development as well, especially Django and Flask. Django is a full-blown web development framework, while Flask is a very lightweight web development platform. So yes, Python can also be learned, and it will also help you in your data journey. So if you know Python, you can excel in both the fields. And when we talk about languages, how we can forget Java? So Java Spring Framework or Spring Boot Framework is something which you can learn. So I've just listed the top three which I feel are in demand. But having said that, C, C++, C Sharp, all these kind of different languages, Ruby, Perl, all these languages are relevant. So you can focus on one language and then you can go for some certification. One certification is AWS Certified Developer Associate. But I would really say that if you really want to focus on this area, it all depends on your hands-on and live projects which you do, how many hackathons you participate in. So it really depends on that. So yes, this is one of the fields or career roadmaps you can choose in 2023. As we have moved from monolithic applications to microservices applications on the cloud, DevOps has become more and more relevant. Today, DevOps is the way to develop, deploy, and manage any microservices application on the cloud. And that's why DevOps is one of the career roadmaps you can choose, especially if you are interested in learning so many different technologies under one umbrella, because DevOps is full of different tools and technologies, right from source code management to managing something with using Terraform, using Chef, Puppet, using Kubernetes. All these different technologies, when merged together, creates this big career as a DevOps engineer, DevOps manager, or for example, DevOps architect. It's a very, very big career path, and you have to have at least 6 to 8 months of learning journey if you want to master all these different small tools. If I just go about taking even the names of these products, it would take me a new specific video for that. So I won't dig into that, but just to highlight something, Azure DevOps is in demand. Azure offers all the different tools within cloud platform, within its cloud platform to manage your DevOps pipeline. Kubernetes is again a field within DevOps which you could really master, and there are specific roles purely based on Kubernetes. So to manage all your container-based applications, you need Kubernetes as an orchestration platform. I have a specific video on Kubernetes if you want to understand the fundamentals of it. And then you can also go for tools, certifications in specific for Terraform or other different tools and technologies in DevOps. As we have moved on the cloud, cybersecurity has emerged as one of the very important areas to look for. There is a huge gap when it comes to current job market versus role fitment when it comes to cybersecurity. There's a lot to be done in this area, and that's why we need a lot of professionals in cybersecurity. So if you want me to create a dedicated video on the roadmap as a beginner you have to choose to enter into the field of cybersecurity, let me know in the comment section, because it will take me a dedicated video to explain that, and also I have to do some research. But at a very high level, cybersecurity again have roles which are in plenty, but some basic roles and popular roles are cybersecurity analyst, cybersecurity consultant. All these people work to strengthen your security posture on the cloud. Penetration testers tries to enter and find out vulnerabilities in your applications. They try to break into your code and see how an attacker can attack your application. So if you come from a network background or a network security background, you could think of entering into cybersecurity. It does not demand a huge amount of coding knowledge, although you need to have some level of scripting knowledge. But yes, it could be a field for you if you come from an infrastructure security background, a very, very prominent and a promising career roadmap. So the top two certifications, in my opinion, which are huge in demand, are CISSP, which is Certified Information System Security Professional, I guess, and CISM, which is Certified Information Security Manager. These certifications are costly, but if you can do that, I can bet that you would be in demand. So what is the end goal? Like, what you think could be the end goal of computers? And I think that would be to replicate humans. And that's why artificial intelligence and machine learning, which is our seventh career roadmap, becomes so interesting. All the leaders today, be it Meta, be it Google, be it any tech giant, be it any business, everyone accepts that actual future lies in the hand of artificial intelligence and machine learning. If you really want to get into this, I think if you have the data background, it is an extension of your data science field. So that's why if you come from a data background, moving into AI and ML would be very, very intuitive for you. But having said that, anybody who wants to pursue this could find a track. There are various courses available, but you need to understand what kind of a role you are targeting. Whether you want to become a data scientist, an ML engineer, what kind of things, or maybe a BI developer. Having said that, it's a long journey. So you have to start with something like Google AI. It is a portal where you could start learning the fundamentals of artificial intelligence. And then it is not about doing a certification. It is because it is a full course. There are people who are giving you master's degree specifically on data science and AI ML. So it is a costly affair if you are just thinking about money. But if you really invest in it, you could get a good leverage. So you can go to Coursera and Udemy. There are dedicated tracks for you to pursue, which could help you in this journey. And if I have to talk about very specific certification, AWS Machine Learning Speciality is one such certification. Now, whatever I have shared with you as far as certifications or courses are concerned, it is not exhaustive by any means. I have just pinpointed one or two which came to my mind. But if I get any other, I'll put it in the description box below so that you can check it out. So this brings us to the end of this video. I have tried summarizing all the different seven tracks which I could think of. And by no means I'm saying that this is the end of the world. There could be, and there is, a lot of different areas and career roadmaps which you can choose. But in my view, in the coming year, if you target any one of these seven tracks as your career roadmap, I think you would reach your goal of making a successful career in 2023. So friends, I hope you got something useful out of this video. If you did, please hit that like button, because that helps YouTube understand that there is something useful going on this channel. Please hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you exactly know when I upload my next video. You can go and check out my other series on networking, on cloud, on data, and learn more about IT industry. As I always say, we make IT interesting for everyone, be it IT or non-IT. So until next time, guys, keep learning, keep sharing your knowledge, and yes, keep hustling. Bye for now.